oil 7400 and oil 7600 Autosampler installation. This video will help you install your oil 7400 or oil 7600 Autosampler with a simple configuration. Here you can see a typical oil 7400 Autosampler. Your Autosampler may have minor differences from what is shown. For additional information, refer to the quick installation guide included with your Autosampler. Before you begin, familiarize yourself with the parts of the Autosampler. In front are the Z-drive assembly, the arm, the rinse station, the cable chain, the power indicator, and the sample tray. Attached to the Z-drive are the stirrer motor, the probe stirrer block, and the drip cup holder. On the back of the Autosampler are the power switch, the power connector, a USB port, two serial ports, an Ethernet port, an auxiliary port, the stirrer connector, the Z-drive connector, peristaltic pumps for oils and aqueous rinse solutions, and rinse station fittings for oil and aqueous. You will be installing the standards racks, the drip cup, the stirrer paddle, either the oil sample probe and tubing, or the aqueous sample probe, rinse and waste tubing, a USB cable or serial cable, and the power supply end cord. Mount the tray and standards racks. The tray ships already installed, but it may come loose during shipping, so check that the tray is securely seated on the base of the Autosampler. Insert the standards racks at the back of the tray. Install the drip cup and stirrer. Press the drip cup into place. Locate the oil stirrer paddle. Place the nut and ferrule on the paddle. Press the stirrer paddle into the hole on the bottom of the stirrer motor. Place the stirrer motor into the larger hole in the probe stirrer block on the Z-drive. Tighten the two thumb screws. Install the sample probe. Choose the appropriate probe for your application. The aqueous probe has an integrated capillary and can be installed directly. The oils probe has a filtered tip. The included capillary must be attached before installation. To attach the capillary, use the short piece of black tubing and insert the capillary and the probe into either end. Once you have selected your probe, guide the probe straight down through the small hole in the Z-drive. Adjust the height of the probe so that the tip is level with that of the stirrer paddle. Tighten the thumb screws. If desired, route the sample tubing through the guide on the top of the Autosampler. Connecting the rinse station. Starting with the oil side, cut two 25 centimeter lengths of tubing. Connect these tubes from the left side of the pump to the two lower fittings on the rinse station. Connect a 1.8 meter length of tubing from the upper fitting of the rinse station to a waste container. Cut two lengths of tubing long enough to reach from the peristaltic pump to the bottom of your rinse solution container. Connect these tubes to the right inlet side of the oils pump. Now, repeat the previous steps on the aqueous side. Power supply and communications. Plug the power supply into the power connector on the Autosampler. Connect either the USB or the serial cable between the host computer and the Autosampler. Power on the Autosampler. Switching between oils and aqueous applications. To switch from oils to aqueous, simply slide the rinse station to the right, change the sample probe, and remove the oils paddle. When you move the rinse station, the status LED will change from green for oils to blue for aqueous. The peristaltic pump switches automatically. You're all done. Your autosampler is now ready to use.